giddy up. Come on. Not so fast, Roach. Go, go. That's it, Roach. Whoa there, Roach.
Witcher! John Vernon, remember? He saved me from the drowners. It was copperless then. Now, why, my purse is bursting.
Mm-hmm. With coin that belonged to the refugees. Vengeance tastes sweet.
I thought you'd come for your reward. I'll gladly pay, mind you. You've saved my life, no two ways about it. But if you're looking for a bruising, well, you'll find it.
Should have left you there, tied up, right at the water's edge.
Well, you can't turn back time. But I'm willing to see to it your conscience don't torment you long. Get him!
Show me what you got.
Greetings.
Wouldn't mind a look at your stock. Farewell.
Where you belong.
Fuck. Sick of it all.
All right.
Quite a lot of time.
Oh, good job.
Look at the freak.
Run to it.
Oh, I wish my man were as brave as you. And he'd kill me since he can't collect them.
You won't see.
Come closer. Don't be
shy. It is true. I just smear ash on their lips first. That's why I don't hurt.
That's all it takes.
We can't use you.
No, soap too. We can try it at home later.
Nice!
You've nothing.
Barbarian. A woman. An earthman. And looking for shelter. And the element first.
Last chance to surrender all orthodox books.
Place her off with the stage.
Grimoires and tracts blaspheming the sacred flame especially.
I think it's rather entertaining.
People die there.
Exactly. And you can fear death or laugh in its face. I prefer the latter.
Mage in their home shall burn alongside him or her.
They say some witches spy for the black ones.
Once there was a little frog, ribbity rock, rock, ribbity rock.
See the empty ship?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, no one knows how it got here. It belongs to.
Mm-hmm. That's all you've got to say.
The right cabin.
The side the other day accused me of this money. That's really.
Excellent goods at the lowest prices. If some mug's got it cheaper, you can be sure the scoundrel's put sawdust in his flour. Interest you in a fritter?
Mind if I have a look? Take care now.
Dye works will only give you ring. Glake leaves you toothless and heads.
Brother! Sister!
Come, sir! Feast your eyes on my lovely baubles.
Let me see what you're offering. Farewell.
Wow. Look.
Beware, freak.
My old ship hasn't my port either.
It hasn't and never will. Oh. You're waiting a letter from your lover? Or is it a fat pouch of coin from family all seeing knackered?
Well, either way, you're waiting in vain.
You're an agent. Why awaiting nothing? I'm just curious what's the delay. Weather's been good, squalls have been passing us by.
But the Imperial Armada's not been. Those savages from Skellig venture nearer and nearer our waters.
Yeah, right.
Ooh, fuck.
You'll not find wood here. Not pain workers.
Drink
us some figgy pudding and bring it right here.
You shan't turn back a river with a rod. Sit, drink.
Nice tune.
You need new breeches? Gauntlets, perhaps? What say you, fair knight?
What have you got there? So long.
Race no fuss, water no wine.
As your glow, and marking
friend.
Times like courtesical flow. They ventured beyond walls by vines entwined, into the unknown the poor barber to find. Bidding them farewell, the gravestones must
like
cover.
It.
They strode briskly on by doubts unencumbered. The witches.
Dark scent of whip await those running riot. Our duchy values peace and quiet.
My own master with a bottle in front of me. It's no disaster, it's like a funnel of bottom.
What is it?
This tourney, quite a dose of pomp and circumstance.
We cherish this tradition. My great-grandmama, Adela Marta, elevated it to its current status. For the longest time, she could not decide whom to wed. Meanwhile, her suitors, and there were swarms, often dueled one another. In their contests, Ademarta saw an altogether comfortable way of picking the prime apple from the bushel of potential husbands, determining who had what she valued most in men. Strength, valor, and cunning. Thus, she commanded them to take part in tourneys, though in the end she chose none of them, and wed instead the youngest son of Nilfgaard's reigning emperor, whom she met on a journey south.
But Beauclair's inhabitants had begun to enjoy the night's sparring.
Very much so. And not only they. The year after, knights from far and wide gathered to face one another for sport and glory. And so it has remained. Though the price has changed. The Duchess's hand and half the duchy are no longer in the offing. Still, Beauclair's tourneys are famed the world over. Of that we are rather proud.
Thanks for sparing the time, Your Grace.
Duty calls.
You got it.
I understand. Understand and approve.
Patrolling on an empty stomach. Oh, dreadful.
Geralt?
Yen, can we talk?
Why? So you can ask me if we can remain friends despite all?
No, I mean...
Come now, Geralt. I know you well enough to know exactly what's going on with you and Triss. Now, I cannot say I'm not tempted to, intervene, but I believe I'll let it lie this time. About that. You came here to fumble your way through an explanation, yet instead of enjoying the show, I went and did your job for you.
Seems so.
But now, Enough of this maudlin business. We've something to do, remember?
Thanks, Yen. See you later.
Yes?
I've got a piece like a racehorse.
I'd give you a discount for heroic deeds, but the madam, well, you know.
Yes, Geralt?
Been in Novigrad long?
Long enough to know how not to get caught and survive.
And before you came here, where were you?
Oh, places. Where I managed to get by without your help, too. Which doesn't mean I'm not happy to see you.
So, there you were in Putrid Grove, and out of nowhere I show up. What did you think?
Honestly? Oh, no, not him again.
Figured as much. You weren't easy to find, you know.
You'd recovered your memory, found Yennefer, so naturally, I thought the two of you...
But it turned out my amnesia changed nothing. Wanted to be with you before, during, after, always.
I know that now.
So long, Triss.
Wild Hunt to take you all. Duty calls.
Got a minute?
Of course.
Once you'd left Yen and me on the Isle of Avalon, what happened to you? What did you do?
I traveled through time, space, different worlds. I saw houses of glass, ran with unicorns at the world's end, even lived in an undersea kingdom for a time.
Freedom. Always had a taste for it.
I still do.
So why'd you return?
It was too much. I almost drowned in it. When everything is possible, it quickly becomes a lot less alluring.
Traveling between worlds, what's it like?
It's nice.
Difficult?
It was at first, but in time it became automatic, like riding a horse.
Bet a lot of mages would love to learn to do it.
I'm certain they would. But Avalok claims they've neither the knowledge nor talent. He spent 4 centuries learning to do it, yet can still only find and pass through pre-existing portals. I go wherever I please, whenever I please.
I should go.
All right. We'll talk later.
Yes, Geralt?
How'd you find me? Kavir's a long way off.
I have my ways, Geralt. Hydromancy, for example.
Oh yeah, that's right. So, what becomes of us? See anything else in the reflection?
Mm-hmm. Zoltan moves in.
Please tell me you're joking.
You can breathe easy. Far as I know, he settled down in Novigrad and has no intention of budging. In all seriousness, though, I did see a few scraps of our future, but I'd rather not tell you exactly what.
Why not?
Because you said you've grown to like pleasant surprises.